Captain, come in. You may stand at ease.
I understand you've succeeded in bringing Havoc Squad up to full strength, Captain. Congratulations.
My squad and I are very proud to be a part of this operation, sir.
I think I speak for everyone when I say we're glad to have Havoc involved. General Garza, why don't you begin?
Certainly. As you know, Captain, the Gauntlet's superweapon allows the Empire to target and destroy any ship traveling through hyperspace. This capability, if put to use, would give the Empire an insurmountable advantage. It also makes an attack on the Gauntlet itself extremely difficult.
Fortunately, the technical data you helped retrieve allowed us to determine a safe approach pattern that will get our forces within striking range.
It's good to know the attack won't end before it begins.
The plan is not without its dangers. Commander Rance can explain.
We've run the numbers from the Imperial's readouts and determined the Gauntlet's minimum time to acquire and lock onto a target.
Your ship and those of my battle group will approach the Gauntlet by making numerous short hyperjumps, always remaining below the minimum lock-on time. Short, repeated hyperjumps are very inefficient. Once we're in, our warships won't have enough fuel to return. Total victory will be our only option.
Failure has never been an option, sir.
Quite right.
When the attack begins, Lieutenant Coria's safecrackers will immediately disable the planetary shield generator that protects the Gauntlet, allowing Havoc Squad to board it.
Once you're aboard, begin the demolition operation. Sergeant Yuen will help you bypass the security seals on the weapon's inner core. Specialist Vic will then go into the core with you and plant explosives at key weak points, ensuring the Gauntlet's total destruction.
How should I deploy my other squad members?
During your demolition operations, two Havoc Squad members of your choice will assault the Gauntlet's bridge and download all data from the weapon's computers. Unassigned squad members will provide mobile backup to the rest of the team as needed. As soon as your objectives are complete, evacuate the Gauntlet immediately. Understood?
I'll assign the bridge assault team before the attack begins.
We cannot overemphasize the importance of this mission, Captain. The future security of the Galactic Republic hinges on the destruction of this single weapon.
You and your team are no strangers to situations like this. You've faced incredible odds before, and overcome them with skill and determination. If anyone can lead the charge in this battle and see us through to victory, it's Havoc Squad. Your Republic is counting on you. Move out!
For the Republic!
Yeah!
This is Admiral Newman. Our attack group has exited hyperspace and engaged the Imperial's escort ships. Defensive forces are as expected. Lieutenant Coria reports that the safecrackers have breached the planetary shield generator. You're clear to make your run on the Gauntlet. Good hunting.
Give the Imperials a run for their money, sir.
We'll be in contact if anything develops. Newman out.
I got the team prepped and ready for your assignments, Captain. We're all eager to do some damage. Like Garza said, we'll need two for the assault on the bridge. Getting in there will be a fight. Vic and Yuen are spoken for, so that leaves me, Dorne, and Forex to hit the bridge. Who do you want on the job?
Sergeant Dorne knows the Imperial systems, and Forex can take the heat.
All bridge data will be collected and returned without error, sir.
No Imperium will stand in our way. The Republic will triumph.
We'll make the final adjustments before we land. Any other words for the team?
Havoc is the best squad in the Republic because it has the best soldiers in the Republic. And that's why we'll succeed. We may be charging headfirst into the most advanced weapon of war the Sith Empire has ever built, but we will succeed. The odds may be impossible. The enemy may outnumber us 10-1. But Havoc Squad will succeed.
Sir, yes, sir.
Move out and find the rest. Couldn't have done it without you, Yun. Time to contact Vic. Vic, come in. The seals are disabled. Rendezvous at the core access door ASAP. Over.
That ugly bug got you through after all, huh? Heading for the door. Vic out.
That's the spot. One down, Captain. Let's hit the rest so we can get back to Coruscant and the many thankful citizens of the Republic.
Medals, parades, parties? Heh, this could be great.
These crazy missions do have their advantages. I'll follow your lead.
Relief to see you well, in spite of the extensive fighting. I'm afraid that Doran was injured terribly while we were fighting our way back to the ship. I attempted to absorb as much incoming fire as possible, but she refused to hide. She insisted on ensuring that I returned as well.
What's her status? Is she going to make it?
It's been a long time since medical basics, but Yun and I managed to patch her up. If Forex hadn't gotten her back so fast, we would have lost her.
It was very brave of you to get Dorne out of there.
The Republic does not leave its heroes behind. I did only what duty required.
Could we talk about this later? I need to set those charges off, and we shouldn't be sitting in the hangar bay when I do.
Let's get moving. Double time it. Attack group, this is Havoc. Objective complete. All ships evacuate to minimum safe distance.
We copy, Havoc. All ships are clear. Proceed with the detonation.
Boom.
Destroyed. All ships disengage and proceed to rendezvous 474 refueling. Havoc, return to General Garza on Coruscant for debrief.
I'll proceed to Coruscant immediately, Admiral.
The Empire's greatest weapon has been destroyed. Congratulations, Havoc.
Finish this, or should I pop out for a drink?
Too bad the imps didn't put a bar on this thing. Could use a break. Sergeant Yoon, you're dismissed. Rendezvous with Sergeant Jorgen and stay alert.
That's the last of them. We'll be good to go in just a few seconds.
Captain, sir. Sergeant Dorne, a situation has developed on the bridge. All data has been retrieved, but Imperial reinforcements are overwhelming our position. We can't hold them. Are your explosives in place? Are we clear to return to the ship?
Our objectives are complete. I want you all back aboard the ship on the double.
Roger that. Let's move out.
Yes, sir.
Captain, fantastic work. The Imperial Ministry of War is a firestorm over the Gauntlet's destruction. The SIS says that heads will roll over this, quite literally.
If the Imperials are busy fighting over blame, this is the perfect time for more strikes.
A good thought, actually. I'll have the SIS work up a priority listing of targets of opportunity right away. Your leadership and skill in conducting this ongoing operation have been exemplary. I'm promoting you to the rank of Major, effective immediately. Commensurate promotions will be issued to your squad members as well. Congratulations, Major.
I'm honored to accept this promotion, General.
You've earned it. When presented with extraordinary circumstances, you have delivered extraordinary results. I'm also recommending you for the Silver Crescent, in honor of the extraordinary valor you demonstrated in the attack on the Gauntlet superweapon. In recognition of the injuries she suffered in action against the enemy, I've recommended Ilara Dorne for the Mark of Dedication. That is, if you approve.
M14X risked himself to save the life of a squadmate. Doesn't he deserve something for that?
Droids serving in the Republic military are classified as equipment, not personnel. There is no precedent for granting a droid any sort of commendation. But if you feel strongly on the matter, I can see about having his contributions recognized appropriately. Now, I'm afraid that not all of our news is positive. We received the following holotransmission not long after the Gauntlet was destroyed.
Republic Command, I am General Racton of the Imperial Ministry of War. You have made a grave error. By destroying the Gauntlet, you have destroyed a weapon of peace and the final hope your people had.
A weapon of peace? That's ridiculous.
This is only the beginning.
I had hoped a device that removed the possibility of resistance would allow the Empire to achieve its great works without further bloodshed. But your actions have destroyed any hope for peace. I am forced to launch a campaign unlike any the galaxy has seen. Your soldiers will be slaughtered, your planets will burn, and your people will embrace the light of the Emperor's will at last.
If the Empire is about to begin a full-scale campaign against us, our forces need to be ready.
We're putting all outposts and units on alert immediately. For years, General Racton has outmaneuvered and outwitted every Republic force that has stood in his way, including mine. The SIS is watching for any sign of Racton's new campaign. Until we have solid data, Havoc Squad is relieved. Rest, recuperate, and be ready for my call. Dismissed, Major.
Major, this is General Garza. I need you to report to my office on Coruscant immediately. General Racton made his move. The Imperials have invaded dozens of Republic planets. Havoc Squad is needed, immediately.
Is there a plan for dealing with this invasion, General?
I'll brief you on the details when you arrive. Move quickly. Garza out.
Major, stand at ease. Let's get straight to the situation at hand. After we destroyed the Gauntlet, General Racton called a diplomatic summit with the heads of state of several Republic allied planets along our borders. The summit was held aboard a neutral space station, where Racton's troops seized the heads of state by force. They are now hostages of the Empire.
I wouldn't have expected anyone to fall for peace talks with the Empire.
Public pressure to attend peace talks is quite high. This war has people understandably terrified. With their leaders held hostage, our allies are allowing Imperial troops to pass through their systems and strike us where we're vulnerable. Our forces are at their limit. The Imperials will overwhelm us unless we rescue these heads of state and block Racton's invasion routes.
What's our intel on the hostages' location?
The station where the heads of state are being held is called Outpost 256. Imperial security is tight, but we've developed an entry plan. Helic, a diplomat for one of these worlds, is flying there to surrender his government's security codes. He's volunteered to sneak your team aboard.
It takes a lot of guts to fly into a hostage situation.
Yes, he's taking a great risk for us. Let's make the most of it. Your ship will ride alongside Helic's, detaching at the last second and landing in an unused maintenance hangar aboard the station. Lieutenant Yun will slice into the station's security and stop any alarms from sounding while you storm the crew area and secure the hostages. Understood?
I'm ready to begin immediately, General.
Helic will rendezvous with you at these coordinates. The Imperials are expecting him to deliver his security codes very soon, so move quickly. Remember, The safety of the Republic depends entirely on the safety of these men. Good luck.